In this video, I'm gonna show you a simple way that you can reduce that annoying audio noise in the background of your videos. Hi, I'm Andy from TechSmith, where we help you show what you know. Recording clean audio can be a pain, but having to reduce background noise after recording can be even harder. This is where noise reduction or removal comes in. It's a powerful feature in many audio editing applications that can help you target and eliminate those unwanted sounds in your video. It's important to note, there is no magic bullet when it comes to noise reduction, and nothing beats recording clean audio to begin with. In fact, check out our other video linked here on how to record a voiceover, even from home, to get some best practices before you hit record. But when you don't have the option to re-record cleaner audio, noise reduction can be a lifesaver. Let's explore how to clean up your audio inside of TechSmith Audiate. Audiate allows you to skip most of the technical aspects of audio editing, so you can quickly get the results you want without having to be a sound engineer. You'll need to have an audio file, so if you're using an MP4 or video file, first, export it from your video editor, such as Camtasia, as audio only. Inside of Audiate, we can add the WAV file we want to reduce noise on into the work area. It will take a minute to transcribe depending on the length of your audio. This is one of Audiate's key features. You edit the words, not the audio waveform, making it accessible for anyone regardless of skill level. All right, now that it's been transcribed, let's play that back so we can hear what our audio sounds like to begin with.
Add the sum to the product of these three.
Did you hear the noise in the background? Let's apply a noise reduction effect by going to the bottom right-hand corner, clicking the sliders icon, which will open the audio effects menu, then click on the plus sign to add an effect and select remove noise. Once we have this applied, we're given a few different options. Let's go through what each of these does so you can dial in the best results for your clip. Okay, let's start with processing. Processing adjusts the overall amount of noise reduction. Slide this up and the overall amount of noise goes down. Be careful adjusting any of these parameters too much, as you'll hear if you bring this up too high, you start to lose some of that voice and begin to get a tin can or underwater sound.
Add the sum to the product of these three.
With audio editing, less is usually more. Next is the output, which adjusts the overall loudness of your clip. Use this to bring back any volume you lost. Remove hum or buzz is off by default. If you're still hearing either of these in your audio, switch it on to target those specific types of noise. Finally, the frequency drop-down menu allows you to target specific frequencies if you know what frequency your noise happens to be at. Or heck, feel free to play around with it and see the differences that each frequency makes as you target it. Everything that's done can be undone.
Add the sum to the product of these three.
It may take some time adjusting and listening back to your audio until you get it just right, but remember again, less is more. One last tip. I like to listen using my headphones first, and then go back and listen through my computer speakers, because the two different playback methods will sound very distinct from one another. So this will give you some perspective on how your audience might hear it. That's it. It's really that simple to improve your audio quality just by removing a little bit of noise. What's another tip that would help you make better videos or audio? What are you wondering? Let us know in the comments below. If you enjoyed this video, give it a like, and click subscribe if you want to be notified when we release more great content. Thanks for watching.